Hello YouTube vinyl community. Lovely, gorgeous, sunny, warm day here in Britain. This video is a Fred response, and it's one that's right up my alley, to be honest. James Griffiths and his Play It Loud Fred, which he started a couple of weeks ago. If you don't know James, well, I'm sure you all do. Fantastic channel, really, you know, really, really great bloke. He puts a lot of thought into his Fred type videos. Very well spoken, very knowledgeable about music. Great bloke. I'll put a link to this Fred of his in the description. Get on over, have a look. Have a go. It doesn't cost you a penny, does it? Anyway, before we sort of get to the real meat on the bones, I suppose. Honourable mentions. Use Your Illusion 2 album. Oh, by the way, these three I'm going to show you, I don't own vinyl copies. Use Your Illusion 2 album, Guns N' Roses. Civil War. Put It On, bang the sound right up, Play It Loud at Your Grandma. Heavy rock, heavy metal really lends itself to this sort of Fred. You Could Be Mine as well. Brilliant tune from the Terminator films. I saw Guns N' Roses at the Milton Keynes Bowl years ago, back in the 90s. I think it was quite possibly the Get in the Ring tour. Matt Sorum did a fantastic drum solo sort of intro into You Could Be Mine. Brilliant stuff. Get It On, Turn It Up Loud. This band, Slipknot. I think it's New Age rock or New Age metal, they call it. Christ almighty, what a revelation this lot were when I first sort of discovered them. I don't mind a bit of Slipknot. I couldn't listen to it all the time. It probably do my head in, but fantastic band. Great, huge, worldwide success. Tracks like Left Behind, which is the first Slipknot tune and video I ever saw. Bit of a wow moment for me back then in the day. Duality, Psychosocial. There's others I can't think of, but yeah, Slipknot. Again, a band, a genre that really lends itself to this Fred of James's. I went through a bit of a Metallica phase a few years ago. Gave up on sort of usual music I sort of grew up with and loved to listen to, and I've gone back to today. The Kerrang channel and music sort of TV channels like that, MTV as well. Metallica, this is a live album, S&M, the orchestra, No Leaf Clover. Fantastic tune that is, my favourite Metallica track. So moving on, so I've got a big wad of records down here to show. This Fred idea of James really lends itself to driving songs. Get in the car, get the old stereo on, get the window down. Let's get down and get with it with the boy racers and all that malarkey. First one up, Wheels of Steel, Saxon, great driving tune. Again, lends itself to this, let's put them over there, this Fred of James's. One I do like to sort of bang up and listen to when I'm driving along. This Corrosion, this is extended version by the Sisters of Mercy. Again, a fantastic driving tune. Get the sound right up loud. Perhaps the perhaps the ultimate, let's put that there, perhaps the ultimate driving tune now. Let me put the volume up loud. She Sells Sanctuary, the Cult, slightly extended version. I mentioned Guns N' Roses, seeing them in concert years ago. The Cult were actually supporting them. And I remember standing there in the crowd with my mates and all that, and not long now to the Cult are coming on the stage. I really want to hear She Sells Sanctuary. My mate Austin, either don't play it no more, but you won't hear it. What happens? The Cult comes on, She Sells Sanctuary. Fantastic. A band, perhaps my favourite band of all time now, but I like to play some of their tunes really loud. I'll grab hold of it. The Who, Won't Get Fooled Again. Perhaps my favourite Who track of all time. This one I got from Finmere Market Donkeys years ago, probably back in the 90s, I should imagine. 15 quid it cost me back then, worth a bit more now. You need 3D glasses, it all comes out in 3D. There's the other side. Yep, love The Who. Again, turn it up loud. Perhaps the greatest teenage anthem of all time. The Who again. My Generation. There's the back cover. Most people think it reached number one here in Britain. Only reached number two. Shame, really. And again, The Who. The Real Me. The main sort of opening tune, with all the credits, etc., and the film title at the start of the film, Quadrophenia. And yeah, and a bit of a segue on this album as well, I just realised. So, yeah, I might have a go at Rob Ison's Fred as well. But yeah, The Real Me, The Who. Again, get it on, bang it up loud. Now, if this idea of James really lends itself to a genre, or genres, we've had metal, hard rock, new age rock, metal, then it's punk. So yeah, the granddaddy of them all, Never Mind the Bollocks. That's the free single that came with the original pressings of this album. Lucky to have found that at a car boot sale years ago. If there's one Sex Pistols tune I do bang up really loud, it's Bodies. Another punk track, sort of speed punk, UK 82 by The Exploited. This one's for Bill at Vinyl Lists. Great Scottish punk band, The Exploited. Watty Buchan, lead vocals, Big John Duncan on guitar, Gary on bass, and Danny doing the drums. UK 82 from the film. It's either made in Britain or made in Great Britain, I can't remember. All about a lad, Trevor, who's a bit of an oi type skinhead, bloody racist, but spends all the movie hanging around with a black kid. There you go. Again, great play it loud at your grandma type tune. UK 82, The Exploited. Another one I love to bang the sound up really loud to. Yeah, another punk track, speed punk one. Sort of great beat to it, and that. The lyrics you're probably never going to understand. It's a lot of this sort of speed punk sort of stuff is sort of shouting and screaming. I love it though. Yeah. Band's called Chaos UK, song's called No Security. It is there on YouTube. I'm going to put links up to some of these. Put your headphones on, bang the sound up, give it some beans. UKDK was a sort of punk video type film back in the day, where this no security. Tracks come from, let's go down to some 7-inch singles, Punk, Sham 69, The Kids Are United, great, great, great British punk band Sham 69 were on the Polydor label. You can see that okay. Yeah, they're back together and that, and in one guise or another. I don't think it's the exact lineup. Jimmy Percy's still fronting them. Sham 69 blighted by what you can only describe as absolutely bastard racists back in the day, who because Sham 69 played the played a no racism type gig back in the day, as did The Clash, Tom Robinson, people like that. The racists sort of turned up at their gigs, caused trouble, fighting, big punch-ups. Of course, the police and that involved, and Jimmy Percy just had enough. He walked away from it all, just didn't want anything to do with it anymore. Like he said in the Don Letts film, Story of Skinhead, do you really think I wanted anything to do with this racist scum, you know? That's what they were. Sham 69, back, gigging. Great, great band they were. Another speed punk one really lends itself to James's Play It Loud, Fred. Sick Boy by GBH, another great British punk band. Fantastic tune that is. Let's sort of carry on with that sort of punky sort of theme. It's an Oi album, Skinhead Oi, street punk compilation, and the track on here, a great, great favourite of mine. It's by I believe a Scottish band as well, Oi Polloi, and the track is called Skinhead. It's very much into the Skinhead movement back in the 80s, but gave it up eventually for different reasons, perhaps go into in another video. But yeah, another firm favourite of mine, that's Skinhead by Oi Polloi. Bit of psychobilly now, British psych, perhaps the top psychobilly band in the world at the moment. The Meteors, they do have studio albums. I think they've done over 40 studio albums. But the Meteors, for me and a lot of people, best seen and heard live. And this one's live from Glasgow. Another one there for Bill, from back in the 80s. I've seen them live a few times. Fantastic, fantastic psychobilly band. Again, get it on your turntable, your CD player or whatever. Bang it up loud. A few singles. It's free from one band. One more album, and I've saved the best, probably the most obvious single till last. One Step Beyond Madness. Yeah, that sort of driving ska saxophone beat from Lee Kicks Thompson, who, oh, let's put them so they don't slide off the bed. There he is there at the back. And of course the chant, One Step Beyond, from Chaz Smash. Absolutely fantastic. A bit of a call to arms for us back in the day, this was. Another one I love to play loud. Loud and proud. Queen. Probably not so obvious in this, Fred. But my favourite Queen track of all time, Fat Bottom Girls. Another one I like to play really, really loud. Bit of a chanting theme to that. Oh, I'm gonna take you home tonight. Absolutely brilliant song. I do love to play it loud. Loud and Proud. Favourite Queen track, Fat Bottom Girls. B-side, Bicycle Race. Not so keen, I will sing along to it, but Fat Bottom Girls is the one I do like to play loud. Again, this idea, this thread, sort of lends itself to this one by Queen as well. We Will Rock You. That great sort of chant, and it's the one that sort of gets the crowd sort of whipped up and they're clapping along and singing along. I used to stand at the back of the old sheds and the terracing at the football and bang along and to this sort of tune and try and get the fans sort of shouting and chanting. Again, another one on the other side that lends itself to this Play It Loud theme. We Are The Champions by Queen. Of course, I play it at football. Especially when it's the end of the season and the team's won the Premier League or whatever, or the division they're playing in. Another one of my favourites by Queen. I like to play loud. Loud and Proud, Seven Seas of Rye. Great, great song. Absolutely love it. Moving on, one last album, Slade. This one, Slade Alive. Slade, one of the greatest British bands of all time. More to them than that Christmas hit. Here's the other side. I won't get it out and open it up. Yeah. Six number ones in 2 years, absolutely fantastic. Great sort of loud rocking tunes. I mean, at one point, the loudest band on the planet. Noddy Holder, with his loud, raucous sort of voice. Great, fantastic band, absolutely love Slade. And even, you know, songs like Come On, Feel The Noise. Get It On, Bang It Up Loud, Give It Some Beans. Absolutely love Slade, fantastic. Slade Alive, one of the loudest bands on the planet in their time. And finally, if there's one record that definitely lends itself to this theme, this idea, songs that should be played or deserve to be played loud, definitely should be played loud, perhaps the greatest heavy metal song of all time, need I say any more? Great idea, James. Great thread. I hope loads of other people jump on this. There's plenty of scope in there for lots of different songs and tunes, and I'll give you examples of genres that definitely should be played loud. Again, take a look at James's channel. Like, subscribe, leave comment. Get on this thread. Give it a go. It don't cost you nothing, does it? If a fat, simple, toothless, simpleton like me can do it, you can as well. Bless you for tuning in. See you again soon. Cheerio. Oh, my knees. See, my knees crack then.